your child's vaccination is coming up, here's some tips and tricks to how best prepare. Be really honest. Be as honest as you can in how you explain what's going to happen and how things are going to take place. Use language that's age appropriate and explain really clearly why it's important that they have the vaccination. Try to time your conversation as well. You don't want them stewing too long over what's going to happen and building anxiety, but you also don't want to spring it on them at the last minute. They need time to make a little plan and process what you're telling them. Try to use positive language. Little words like hurt and brave catastrophize the vaccination. It's better to use language that's really reassuring and supportive, like it feels different for everyone. I wonder how it will feel for you, and we're going to do this together and get through it. There's lots of resources available to help you talk to your child about vaccination. The Birdie and the Virus books and Birdie Gets a Vaccination are great for little kids. There's also lots of online resources through websites like the Meg Foundation. They've got lots of tips and tricks about how to talk to children, tweens and teens before they have their vaccination. So having a game plan is really important when you're being vaccinated. The more prepared we are, the better we feel. Often kids are really anxious because they don't know what to expect and they don't know what's going to happen. You can find a game plan on lots of websites like the Meg Foundation and the Children's Health Queensland website. A game plan really can be made yourself though. It's really just saying what the child wants to happen before they're vaccinated, during their vaccination and afterwards. It can be things like, I want to do some deep breathing to relax beforehand or listen to music. And during the vaccination, it may be, I want to wear an eye mask and listen to music. I don't want to be told it's happening. I do want to be told it's happening. I want to sit with mum, I want to sit in the chair by myself. And afterwards is the most important bit. It's where the child gets to pick a reward for their successful vaccination. Having a game plan is a great way of giving control to your child in a situation where they may feel like they have no control. We have lots of different ways of distracting children during their vaccination. We've got lots of little bits and gadgets down in the vaccination centre. Sometimes little toys like poppets and up and down toys that you can watch, squishies, VR goggles, phones are great. Usually we involve the Starlight Foundation and the clown doctors here at Queensland Children's, but you can do really simple things like sing with your child, tell a joke, tell a story together. Anything that's going to take their mind off the vaccination usually works really well. So after your child's vaccination, it's really important that you celebrate their success. It's really hard to front up and do something that you're frightened of, so they've achieved a great thing. Celebrate by whatever they had in their game plan. It might be going out for sushi or receiving a toy or doing something with mum and dad, but it's really important to celebrate that success. It reinforces that what they've done worked and that they'll be able to do it next time. You also need to wait for 10 or 15 minutes after you have your vaccination, so that's a good time to talk about what you're going to do and how you're going to celebrate. So we know that everyone feels pain differently. We've got lots of little tricks and tips that we use in the vaccination centre to help with a fear of pain. So we've got little vibration devices like the Buzzy Bee, which kind of distracts your brain from the needle that's happening. You can also pick up lots of numbing creams from pharmacies without a prescription, but it's really important that you get it in the right spot. If it's not in the right spot, the vaccinator won't be able to vaccinate you where the cream was. If you're not sure about where it goes, maybe bring it in and ask one of the staff to help you put it on, and then go away and have a coffee for 20 minutes to half an hour, depending on what cream you're using. You can use simple things like cold packs. You can rub the area. There's lots of little tricks that you can use. But in actual fact, it's really quick. And lots of kids say that it didn't really hurt that much at all, and they were more worried about it beforehand. We often get asked what's normal for needle anxiety and when it becomes needle phobia. So there is no normal. Different kids need different support to help them get vaccinated. Sometimes we just can't get over the line in the vaccination clinic using all those tips and tricks that we've talked about today, and we need a bit more support. If they've had an unsuccessful attempt at a community clinic or a GP, sometimes it needs a referral to the Queensland Specialist Immunisation Service, where we can assess the child and determine whether they need some more support. Other children within the hospital may be referred to QSIS with other teams, and we can work together to do different things like drive-through clinics, use some medication to get vaccinated, and make an individualised plan so that we can help the child get there in the end.